Hey, what's up guys, welcome back. You're watching for today. So we came back with yet another custom ROM review, but this one is a special one. This is Lunaris-AOSP custom ROM based on the legendary ROM Lineageos 23. Lineageos Android 16 source base is already available and Lunaris OS already started to roll out their Android 16 Lunaris version 3.2 for their officially supported devices. List of all official devices are given in description, but we brought you its custom GSI version which should boot and work on any device. Lunaris OS 3.2 not only provides you the stability and performance of Lineage OS, but it also provides you some unique customizations. So today in this video we are going to check out what's new thing this ROM offers, its bugs and issue for GSI build. So make sure to watch this video till the end. Now without further delay, let's get started. First, we'll check out about device details of this build. Here you will notice that it's showing device name as Nothing Phone 2 because developers have ported this build from official build of this ROM available for Nothing Phone 2. Its Android version is 16 and Lunaris version is 3.2, having legendary easter egg of Lineageos. This is the Omni GApps version of ROM. Maintainer of this ROM is Dozop, who is regularly providing updates for all GSI ROM which he builded. Security patches of this ROM are updated to the latest 1st August 2025. Kernel version is same like stock ROM, builded of ROM is of 11th August 2025. So everything is updated with the latest August 2025 source base. Custom ROM of this build may have different details for kernel version, maintainer and build date. Now we are going to review only new changes I discovered. I will not repeat all Android 16 features in this video. For that, please check video given in iCard. ROM developers implemented their own user interface touch for Android 16 Mattel U3 expressive design. Like here in quest panel, you will find the new quest design look. All tiles have rounded corners, but animations are same like Android 16 build. Similarly, volume panel's user interface is also revamped in this ROM and it looks very nice. Notification panel also have user interface of Lunaris OS. But the new Android 16 clear all button, new notification shortcut buttons are available here. In the settings of the ROM for slider setting, Lunaris team added this new nice touch which looks better than Android 16 user interface. But on and off toggle switches have same Android 16 user interface. So these are main user interface changes I found. So let's move to the second part of this video, that is customizations available in this ROM. So this is the AOSP ROM, but it added a bunch of useful customizations in the option called as Singularity. All old school custom ROM features are available here, so I will only review some unique features that I found. Under user interface, we get new power menu styles similar like Infinity and Rising OS custom ROMs. Here my favorite one is Cyberpunk. In user interface, we get customization option for device lock and unlock sound. Especially the Minecraft door sound is very interesting. You must try this one once you install this ROM. We also get the volume panel percentage, which displays volume level percentage in volume sliders. In the quick setting option, we get full transparent user interface, which provides you transparent user interface for QS panel. Similarly, we get transparent notification, which also gives same look to notification panel. If you are a fan of pure black theme, we get alternate dark QS tone option, which gives pure black theme to QS panel. We get legacy quick style option, which will provide old Android 15 QS panel look. Except these features, all old school notification features are available in this ROM. In the lock screen option, we got new setting called as Doze Animations, which provides Nothing OS like Doze Animations for AOD display. In the spoofing setting, we get lots of different features, which we already discussed in all old custom GSI ROMs reviews. You need to restart device once you apply all of these settings. But out of these features, only unlimited Google Photo backup is working for me. In the system setting, we get the new feature called as System Haptics, where you can control haptic feedback, intensity of overall system haptics. This ROM offers haptic feedback for lots of different activities, like scrolling distance panel for brightness slider, for volume panel sliders, feedback for top and the end of the pages in overall operating system. In the same system settings, sidebar feature is available, which provides you seamless multitasking using free-form multi-window mode. Most of the ROMs now offers this feature, but in this ROM, expansion, minimization, and pinning of the multi-window screen is much smoother as compared to all ROMs I tried till the date. This is the only ROM which offers the quick switch to switch different launchers. You get three different launchers in this ROM, like quick step, pixel, and launcher launcher. Select your desired one and reboot device. Your new launcher will be ready to use. And as a system and gesture setting, you get three finger gesture, so you can assign lots of different options for this, which will provide you amazing multitasking experience. You also get the new shake gestures, which are highly recommended. This will help you to open multiple tasks just by shaking your device, and it's too much accurate. You get treble setting in this ROM. Here now you get new option called as OTA. So now onwards, you can receive OTA via this option if they are available for your ROM. Except this treble setting provides some OEM-based customizations and some bug fixes settings. So these are all special and some unique features of ROM. Performance of ROM is very fluid. So now we'll check out what are the bugs of this GSI. The major bug I found is a Bluetooth audio. Device connected successfully, but still I can't able to hear sound in my OnePlus earbuds. This is very annoying. This ROM I'm working LTE network and data. Even VoLT calls are working, but after first boot, they are not working. You have to add some settings in the treble application. Open the treble setting, then search for IMS option. Here select create IMS option, then download IMS APK, install it. Next, enable all the toggles and reboot your device. Now LTE calling should work for your Snapdragon devices. All play integrity checks are failing in this ROM, but I am able to use most of secured applications like Axis Bank, Yone SBI, HDFC. All payment applications like Google Pay, Phone Pay are working. I only got issue for Beam UPI payment application. So you may get such issue for some highly secured applications which have their own modification detection system. Unfortunately, Google Circle to search is not working at all in this ROM, but you can follow iCard video to enable Circle to search in any device without using root access. Similarly, Google Assistant Gemini is not working for long press power button and not even for bottom edges swipe gestures. But you can assign three finger swipe gestures for Google Assistant and there it's working. Under display fingerprint is not working, but you can use face unlock as alternative, which seems blazing fast. But fingerprint is working for devices having physical fingerprint buttons. Devices having left side punch hole cutout having issues of misalignment, but you can partially solve it by setting punch hole cutout in a display cutout setting of developer option. So these are all issues I found in a Lunaris OS GSI ROM. Custom ROM users will not face any kind of these bugs because they have dedicated development for their devices by Lunaris team. While bugs may vary as per device you are using for GSI version of this ROM, the only annoying bug for me is a Bluetooth which is not working at all, except that other can be solved as I mentioned earlier. In my opinion, if developers will continue support for such Lineageos 23 based ROM, this will be top contender in the AOSP ROM list soon. This is all about for today guys, hope you liked our work, then please do like and share this video, subscribe to our channel, press the bell icon for notifications of our upcoming content. Thanks for watching, see you next time, take care, bye bye.